Perfect. Good morning, guys. Thank you for joining me this morning. So we were discussing about Hive, and before classes we had Hive session 1 and session 2. Today you are going to talk about Hive session 3. By today we'll complete Hive completely. Okay, so in the Hive session 1 we were talking about what is Hive, what is Hive architecture, what is Hive Metastore, what is Hive Server 2, what is Thrift Service, and how Hive architecture works in coordination with HDFS. What is the data in HDFS? What is the data in Hive? And how these differences can really make a Hive a kind of skeleton structure on top of HDFS. I have shown most of things practically while slides were theoretical. So today I would like to continue with the rest of the important things which are necessary for you to understand well, so you can do things pretty good. Okay, before I start this one, I want to check with you if you have had a chance to go through old recordings, or if you have any questions, shoot me. Any questions, anyone? Okay, that's fine. Now, so till this point we are clear. I have shown you very clearly. I have created one manage table. I created an external table. I also created an external table with different location. Three things. These three things I have done. I have loaded data, and I also proved when the data is loaded, the initial data locality is moved from that location into Apps Hive Warehouse. I also proved you practically that if I delete an external table, the underlying data is not removed. But if I delete a table in manage table, the underlying data is also deleted, which is proven with the practical examples. So let's continue with the next part of it. Now, this is what it is. Now, joining two tables means, guys, to perform an outer join, performing queries means very simple. The following select statement selects all records from the customer table. Select start from customers. You can use a familiar where clause to specify which rows to select from the table. So select start from orders table from customers. So to show you practically, for example, if you see here, first to validate that, let me go and import all the tables. I'll explain this scope later for you, but now to explain this practical thing, I'll import all the data into scope. Bear with me for 1 minute. Let me check with import all. Yeah. I'm importing all tables from MySQL, guys. I'll show you what I'm doing. Bear with me. So, scoop. Okay, exit. Exit. Let me go on gateway node. Scoop. Scoop version not showing up. What's wrong? That's okay. Let me not worry about it. What I'll do is I'll do this one. Okay. And warehouse directories. Apps hive warehouse. And my database name is Hadoop ThoughtFox.db. I'll explain Scoop later. I'm just trying to import the data from MySQL into my this thing. Okay, bear with me, I'll explain you what I'm doing. Or let me do like this. This will be a bit confusing for you. I don't want to bother you for that. Let me do it this way. Okay, I'm just copying the syntax, guys. Let me tell you something. What I'm doing here is I'm importing all my relational database management system tables, which is in MySQL, into Hive. Once those data is copied into Hive, I can show you how I can join those outer join, inner join, all these things. Okay, so you'll have to bear with me for 1 minute. This is what it is. Hive import, hive override, create hive. You can use how many of mappers you want, no problem at all. Okay, scoop import, username, password. hyphen hyphen I. So it's not warehouse directory, it should be this one. Okay, guys, simple. So what I'm doing is I'm asking Scoop to import all my tables. I'm asking it to connect to this one, which is JDBC MySQL gateway01.itvarsity.com. And in that MySQL, I'm asking it to connect to database called retail_db. And I also given retail_db as a database name. I also given password. I'm asking it to insert as text file. And this is the syntax for text file. If you see here, as text file, as text. Do you see that? As text file. So I don't think I need to put a line here. Okay, .db. This is hive home, which means you are telling this is the ThoughtWorks, in ThoughtWorks database directory, it has to create. You are creating three mappers. You are asking Hive to import, and you also create Hive tables. Okay, let me see what happens. Scoop import all tables, which is perfect. Let me check if I'm doing anything wrong. Let me see, Scoop is running in the bear with me, guys, I'm showing something. Yeah, Scoop is there, it's working. When you say it's detected, it says Scoop is working fine, no problem at all. So now Scoop import all tables, connect JDBC MySQL, perfect. Use, yeah, this is the problem. This is the problem. Username is equal to retail_DBA, not username retail_DBA. This is the problem. That's one thing. Sorted. Password IT Varsity. And text file. Hive home apps. Hive warehouse. Warehouse directory. And this one will be M3. Access denied for retail_DBA. So let me see if I give retail_DB. Let me check the username and password for read_db. I have written it somewhere. I'm checking it. If you are done with these joins, we are done with the hive perfectly. Hive partitions and all these things. Yeah, I got it. Development is all about this kind of things, so you'll have to be very careful. This is namenode01.itversity.com and the database name is retail_db is the database name and the username is retail_dba. Okay, hyphen h and password is given. Perfect. Let me see now. Now if you see here, user Hadoop ThoughtWorks already exists. That is fine. What I'll do is, copy Hadoop fs minus ls, paste. Okay, so what I'll do is Hadoop fs minus rm minus r. So now Hadoop fs minus ls user Hadoop ThoughtWorks. I deleted it. Okay. Whatever I have in here, I'll delete it. Now if I say here Hadoop fs minus ls, there should be nothing. Guys, the only reason why I'm doing is I already have the directory created. That is the reason it's not taking it. Now I'm doing once again so that it won't fail. Okay. Very simple to explain you how joins works. I'm going to scoop out. I'm going to import all the data of MySQL from MySQL read_db database into my Hive database. My Hive database is Hadoop_ThoughtWorks. So all those tables should come and fall under my database Hadoop_ThoughtWorks. Okay. If you see here, it has moved categories table already. Already exist. Okay, let me now go to Hive. Show databases use Hadoop ThoughtWorks, show tables, okay, DFS minus LS, apps, hive, warehouse, तुम मेरा माय फ्रेंड। Again, this is created. I have to drop it off because that's where it will dump the. You will have to bear with me once I get the data into Hive. After that, we can rock off. I don't have anything now, that's good. Let me see if it works now. Okay, it started categories table. Very good. Applications started. Connected resource manager started. Split three jobs. Number of splits equal to 3. Very good. MapReduce 0%, let dissolve 0%, very good. The MapReduce job is running to do the work. Map is 100%, very good. Very good. Now, categories is loaded. This is categories table. It's still running. Categories table, okay. Departments table, okay. It's doing the work, let it do the work. Perfect. Orders table, order items table. Very good. Good job. Go ahead. Guys, see, very, very, very simple. Categories table copied, customers table copied, departments table copied. Okay, let's wait. It's doing the work. So now, this is just a rough example. Your Scoop is importing everything from MySQL of NameNode into SDFS of your Hadoop. As I said, import all tables. It is importing all the tables from ReturnScoreDB database. Okay. Very good. Very good. Very good. Good job. Go ahead. That's done. Okay. Now, if I go to Hive, if I use Hadoop ThoughtWorks, show tables, see orders table, order items table. Now, if I say select describe orders table, you got it. Describe order underscore items table. Try to understand something, guys. Try to understand something. This is order ID. Okay. This is order item order ID. Okay. So, which means if you want to join two tables, there should be at least one common column in both the tables so you can join them. Okay. Now, there are different kind of joins. Inner join, outer join, and performance oriented joins and all these things. Before jumping into joins, you always have to verify what is that you have as a common column in both the tables. Okay. For example, if you see here, select star from orders table, limit file records. Okay. Select star from order underscore items table, limit file records. Sorry, spelling mistake. I'll do that once again. Orders table, I'll do once again because I want both records to be like. Now observe something. This bit, the second column here, this second column here, 12224 and 12345. Okay. So looking at now, if you see describe orders table, all the relation I'm trying to making is which one. I'm sorry, I always make this mistake with describe spelling. I'll do that once again because order items limit 5, orders limit 5, describe orders table. Okay, see, order ID is an integer. Okay, now if I describe spelling mistake again. Now see guys, this order ID is 12345. Okay, but this order item order ID and this order ID are same. Okay, now using this relation you can join two tables. That is what I was trying to help you out. Okay, here if you see, you can use a familiar where clause to specify which rows to select from a table. Here he is selecting customers table and orders table from customers table, wherein customer dot customer ID equal to order dot customer ID. Okay, do you have a customer ID here? Yes, you have a customer ID here. Okay, like that, if you describe customers table, okay, your customer ID here, which is int, is equal to order customer ID table. To do that, I'll say select star from, observe carefully guys, you'll have to take both the things from customers table, okay, dot star means all the columns of customer, comma, all the columns of orders, comma, so select star from customers table. Okay, from that you are joining. On what are you joining? You are joining orders table, right? Orders table. What is the condition? Your condition is nothing but your customers table Okay, this is your customers table, right? In this customer table, you are adding with this one. You are joining with this one. So customers dot customers underscore ID is equal to orders dot order underscore ID. Okay. Now see what happens. Okay, cannot recognize inputs near. That is fine. I'll take it off. Customers star dot comma order star dot. Why select star from again that one? Not correct, right? Take off select star from. This is enough. Invalid card reference customers underscore ID. Customer underscore ID. See, it's customer underscore ID, not customers underscore ID. Don't do this kind of mistakes, please. It has launched a job there. It's running the job. It is executing the difference. Okay. Now job is succeeded. Number of reduced tasks is set to 0. Map is 0%. Reduce 0%. Let's see. Map is 100%, reduce 0%. See, these are all the records which have the common thing. Okay, this is how you joins. Guys, try to understand something now. Instead of doing that one, if I say limit to 5 records, now if you again check describe customers table, okay, describe orders table, describe orders, describe customers. Now when I did select star from, if I say describe customers dot star, it will give all the columns of customers. It will also give all the columns of orders. I don't want that. What I'll do is, now I want selective columns. For that one, I'll take order underscore customer underscore ID. Okay. And yeah, that's all I want. I just need this column. Okay. Let me see. If you wanted to spend some time on how joins works, go here. Tutorials point joins. This is the same thing. If you are totally new to joins and if you don't have any idea about it, you can go and have a look over here. It will give you some broad picture. Okay. The same thing we are implementing using Hive. There's no big difference. Sorry, 1 minute. Where is my GoToMeeting link? Okay, I got it. This is the link. If you are new to this one, go ahead there. And I'll also want to show you something. This is what it is, guys. This is how the join works. So the most of the time where we have taken is we have really struggled to correct the statement what we have in Hive. So if you see here, this is the Hive syntax. This scoop syntax, what it has done is it has imported all the tables from retail DB database from your MySQL host, which is present in name node. So you know your MySQL is sitting in name node 01. You know the database, you know the password, you logged into that. Okay. From there, you are importing it. Where are you importing it? You are importing into Hive. Which part of Hive? To Hive database. What are you doing? Import all tables. And also, you have given your database name. So it will go and import all those database into that location. This is what exactly the one part of joins. Now, if you see like this, there are multiple ways of joining the tables. So one highlight thing is to perform outer join, you use outer keyword. Outer keyword is nothing but the same thing from customers. You do add outer join. Inner join means it will give first preliminary columns of the first table. Outer join mean it will exclusively go to the outside part, which is right side of your the table which is involved in the join. It will give you the values of the columns of the right table. Okay. Now, if you observe carefully, in the select above row will be written for every customer, even those without any orders. That is what it is. So apart from the orders, I want to explain you something called Hive partitions. These Hive partitions are so important that if you understand Hive partitions properly, you'll also understand Spark partitions and Spark RDDs also, because they're familiarly working together. Okay, now any questions till this point? Joins and understanding how joins works. I want you to spend some time on inner join, outer join, and all these joints. I have sent you the link. Have a look if you are totally new. If you already have a background on these things, I'm quite fine with that. Any questions, let me know, please. Any questions, anyone? Guys, any questions? If yes, say yes. If no, say no. Simple. Perfect. Thanks. Now, Hive manages the data in its table using files as DFS. We have been discussing about it. Okay. You can define a table to Hive have a partition, which results in underlying data being stored in files partitioned by a specified column or column tables. Guys, understand something. You have a book or you have a record, okay? You are storing all your monthly and yearly expenses, okay? From 2014. 2014 has 12 months, 2015 has 12 months, 2016 has 12 months, and you are in 2017, you finish already 6 months. Now, if you have all the data unorganized, and if you want to pull the record of 2014 May, how difficult that is. Rather, if you have a file, and in each file, if you maintain a subfolder with a marking on it, telling 01, 02, 03, 04, 05, 06, 07 to 012. All the monthly records in one directory, like that, you have 12 monthly directories. On top of it, you have 1 year file. So 2014, you have one file. In that one file, you have 12 tabs, okay, or 12 headings. Like that, you have for 4 years. Partition is also working like that. It partitions your data based on the column you define to partition. For example, if you define the partition based on a column called year, month, and date, if you have insert the data today, that will go into that month's, that year's data. Okay, that is what the partition is. You can define a table to have a partition which will result in the underlying data being stored in files. In files, partitioned by a specified column or columns in table. Okay, being stored in files. This is very important. I'll underline that for you. After that, what happens is partitioning the data can greatly improve the performance of the queries because data is already separated into files based on the column value. What is your column value? Your column value is your month, year, and date. All the July month's data goes into one file. All the June data goes into one file. And all the May data goes into one file. As the data is segregated into files level, when you wanted to query the data, your hive will directly jump into that partition rather than checking whole hive huge data. That is what it is. Now, this will eventually decrease the number of mappers and greatly decrease the amount of shuffling and sorting of data and resulting map reduce job. That is all about hive partition. For example, Suresh and Hemant called me. They said, sir, you have been this is the third batch you're handling. I heard you gave a Spark session really well for a second batch, which happened on April 2017. So what I will do, first I will go into 27 partition. In 27 partition, I have a sub partitions for 01, 02, 03, 04, 05, 06, 07. So after 2017 partition, I'll go to sub partition of May or April or April May ending, which is 04 and 05. There I'll check it, which will be easy for me to give the data what Suresh and Hemant has asked me, because my April data is exclusively in one file. My data is all, my May data is also exclusively in one file. Instead of going from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I directly jumped into 4th month file and 5th month file. This way, I am reducing the amount of time and resources I'm spending on it. Okay? It reduces the shuffling and sorting on top of it. That is what partition is. Okay? Next bit. Use the partition by clause to define a partition when creating a table. For example, if you want to create a table, create a table like this, employee ID int partitioned by department string. Okay. So when you partition by department string, all the computer science goes into one file, all electronics goes into one file, all IT goes into one file, all mechanical goes into one file, like that. Okay, that is the syntax. Create table. This is generic. ID is a column, int is a data type, name is other column, string is data type, salary is other column, double is other data type. Now we have three columns here. In these three columns, your table is created. Perfect. In that, you are exclusively mentioning, please partition this table by department string. Okay. You don't have to define the column here, but you can define it here. Okay, that is what it is. Now, what happens is this will result in each department having its own subfolder. So, see apps, hive warehouse, employees. This is the main directory. Okay, in this main directory, in this table, you have a HR partition, you have support partition, you have engineering partition, you have training partition. So, when Hemant or Suresh ask me about he wants details of support team, my hive will directly go and check here. Rather than go, I'll draw a diagram here. See, my hive can directly go to this table and get data from here. Okay, if it is partitioned, rather it has to go here, go here, go here, go here, go here, and then if else, and come back and check here. Here also it has to go again monthly wise data. Rather than that, if it is partitioned properly, it can increase a lot of performance and it can reduces resources overhead. Now, You can partition by multiple columns, which results in subfolders within subfolders of tables in warehouse directory. I repeat this point. You can partition by multiple columns. It's not just a department string. You can also partition by salary. You can also partition by something else. This multiple columns partitioning will result in subfolders. Now your employee table has HR partition, right? If you do a sub-partitioning or if you do multiple partitions, this HR table will again have two or three sub-partitions. Your HR partition will have two or more sub-partitions. That's what it is. Now let me go back. Here, if you see Hive buckets, I think I have drawn a diagram for Hive buckets somewhere. No? Okay, that's fine. Leave it. Hive buckets. If you see, Hive buckets can be organized, Hive tables can be organized into buckets, which improves an extra structure on the table and the way underlying files are stored. You understood the partitions, right? Buckets is one level extension to partitions. Okay. Now, more efficient queries, especially when performing joins on some bucketed columns. Okay. More efficient sampling. Sampling of data means analyzing the data. Okay. For example, because the data is split into small number of pieces. Guys, why are you partitioning? First example, you are partitioning because you are storing data based upon the categorization. Okay. Second thing is, you are bucketing because your categorized data, you are breaking into pieces. It is easy for the Hive to get the data from a couple of pieces rather than picking it from the whole bunch. Simple. Okay. That is why data is already split up into smaller pieces. Now, buckets are created using clustered by clause. For example, I can show you the practically also. Let me do this bit now. Let me show this one. Because I don't want sessions to be theoretical. Hive table. What happened? Come on. Anybody having any issues with passwords or your lab, let me know. Perfect. Okay, now if I say here, sorry, this is the third password, I have to copy it again. Okay, now if you see here, DFS minus LS apps Hive warehouse, in that you have employees, right? Okay, if you don't have anything there, describe formatted and table name is employees. Okay, observe carefully, guys. Spelling mistake, elegant disguise spelling mistake. Sorry, my C doesn't work properly. You'll have to bear with me for that. Now, observe carefully, guys. Number of buckets is minus one because we have not defined any buckets. Okay. The way how you understand whether it is partitioned or not will be, you'll have to insert some records and see at that time it will change the way it looks. Okay. So, if you describe table now, this is what it is. Okay, now insert into employees table, and values will be, what is the value? ID is 1 and name is Amarnath, and salary is 0000. Okay, and department is information technology. Okay, I say IT. I don't want to waste time on that one. That's it. Okay. Need to specify partition columns because destination table is partitioned. What is the mistake I did here?
It's 6 o'clock.
That is fine. ID, name, string, salary. Need to specify partition columns. I don't think I have to mention partition columns while inserting the data. Let me avoid this table and see if it takes. Just try another method. Leave it with me, guys. I'll sort this out later. I'm really not sure. I have insert into partition data. Do I have to give exclusive clause? I'll check this for you. I'll check and come back. Bear with me. I'll check this because I'm also not sure how to insert data into the partitioned columns because I've never done that. I'll Google this for you. I'll find it out. All my attempts is to show you that when you have data inserted, all your department data will be stored in a different file. Okay. As I shown you earlier, DFS minus LS apps hive warehouse Hadoop ThoughtWorks .db. Like this. First thing, you'll have employees like this. This is employees, right? No. Copy DFS minus LS. Paste. Let's see what it shows here. There's nothing because you have not inserted the data. But once you insert the data, it will have two parts. The first part will have the normal, all the tables information, but exclusively the data that is partitioned by department will be in a different file. That is what my attempt is. I couldn't insert the data for some reason. It can be a syntax problem. I'll sort that out and come back to you. Okay. Now, bucketing is also like that. Okay. Now, if you create the same table with this syntax, let me show you. Paste. Yeah, table already exists. I know. I'll create a new table. Employees underscore buckets. Now, if you see DFS minus LS employee underscore buckets. Okay, there is a directory created. Let me show that. I will find the query to insert the data into partitions. I'll show tomorrow. Don't worry about it. Leave it with me. Okay, so now I have employee underscore buckets created. This buckets, what it does is it splits the data into 16 sub partitions. Okay, because you are splitting the whole data into smaller pieces. When I ask you to give a big file, big book, and ask you to check something in the book, rather than breaking it to multiple pages and giving it to you, it will be very easy for you. Okay, that is what it is. So now we have to question yourself, how does Hive determines which bucket to put a record into? Very, very important. That depends upon, if we have n buckets, the buckets are numbered. If you have 100 buckets, then buckets are numbered from 0 to 99. Okay, and Hive hashes the column value and then uses modulo operator on the hash value. Modulo operator is nothing but one of the condition it passes. Okay, it is a round robin fashion modulo operator that it chooses which bucket to choose and put the data. But it always makes sure it is not putting all that in one bucket. It eventually splits the data across the buckets. That is the important concept you have to understand. Interviewers may ask you, can you tell me how Hive stores the data in buckets? Tell them very clearly, you have partitions created. Your partitioned by column will put the data in those columns which you have specified. Buckets is nothing but it is doing the same work, but it is breaking the huge data into pieces of data. This piece of data follows modulo operandi or modulo operator with the hash value of the column to meet the requirement. Okay. Skewing tables. Skewing tables means, very simple guys, if you see the table statement, customers table skewed by zip 577701, 577702 stored as directories. I know one or more column in my Hive table will have a repeated values. When I know a repeated values are going to occur, I can mark that as a skew table. Okay. I can tell Hive while creating the table, create table name skewed by. Skewed by means this specific column, you will see more repeated values. I am telling this in well advance. So when somebody is trying to query that information, please don't worry. Go ahead and get the data from skew. Okay. See, here is the syntax. If you know that column is going to have a heavy skew, you can specify this in the table schema. That example is create table ID int and stored as directories. Now, by specifying the values with heavy skew, Hive will split those into separate files automatically and take this fact into accounts during the query that it can skip the whole file if possible. That's right. When I know my data is stored into a smaller partitions, okay, or stored as a skew, which has the call values repeated, I'll directly go there rather than querying the whole data in the table. Now, in the customers table above, record with zip 577701, 5702 will be stored in separate files because of the assumption that they have large number of customers with two zip codes. This is how you can increase the performance. You can enhance the performance of your Hive. Very, very important. I have covered almost all the topics in Hive in this one. Okay, now let me go to, this is done. Now, order by, sort by. If you see that, let me show what is order by. Select start from orders limit 5. Okay. Or I can show you this way also. Let me go to Ambari. People who have not attended the last Saturday session, you won't understand this. I'm sorry for that. I know the reason for this. Exit. Hadoop fs minus mkdir user hadoop.works. file already exists. That's fine. Chmod 777 user hello thoughtworks star. Sorry, Hadoop fs minus. Perfect. Now let me try, it should work. ATS test. ATS is application timeline server. Go to yarn, one alert, node manager is available. That's okay, there's some issue going on with the cluster which we can't help. Don't worry about that, which will be sorted. So now what I was trying to show you is order by and sort by. Okay, now use Hadoop ThoughtWorks database. Very good. In that, show tables. Very good. Select star from orders. Okay, limit 10 records. Now order by, if you see the syntax of order by, it just says order by column name. I'll say order by, what's the column name? Order ID. Okay, I don't want that. Select star from orders, order by order ID. It has launched a MapReduce job. Okay, see what happens. It will first, it will put all the orders in an order. Okay, order by ID, sort by ID does the same thing. Okay, now if you describe orders table, okay, let me show you with heading, guys. I'll show you something. Hive header row. Yeah, true. Yeah, this is what I want. I have to execute, yeah, this one, hive.cli.header.print. If I do this one, you will get the data with the columns. Okay, paste it now. Now see the magic. If I say select star from orders limit 5. Now you got heading also. This is order ID, this bit. This is orders table order date, which is this one. Okay, this is orders table order customer ID, which is this one. This is orders order status, which is this one. Now I will perform the same thing. Perfect. Now if you see, I'll order by order status. Okay, order underscore status. I want to limit with 10 records, which is fine for me. If you observe carefully, every syntax what I give is converting into a MapReduce job in the background. I'm trying to show everything practically, guys. Whatever it is there in slides, it has been shown practically. See now, all the cancel orders in one row. Okay, do you see that? Do you see that, guys? I have sorted, I have order ID. Now if I say sort by, see what happens. You see that it has done something, it has done nothing. So which means order by, sort by are both same thing. Okay, order by is a complete ordering of data which is accomplished by using a single reducer. Sort by is data out is sorted per reducer and the syntax will be same. Select star from table name, you can use order or you can use sort by, which is same behavior. Now if you see, the syntax for both is identical, only behavior is different. If the record is more than one, reducer sort by provides partial sorting of data by reducer but not total ordering. Okay, internally we are trying to explain how it works internally, but the results will be more, will be familiarly same thing. Okay, order by implements total ordering across all reducers, and to obtain a parallel total ordering across multiple reducers, you have to select the property. This property, if you set to true, will enhance the performance. That's it. There will not be much differences. Okay. Cannot organize input in Hive. So I think we need to add a jar file for that one. Hive.optimize.sample.order.by. I never tried it, but which is fine. Which is fine. But just remember, if somebody asks you how you can optimize a Hive query when you use order by, tell them you have an optimized dot sampling which can be done. Okay. Now, if you do not set the property above, the total ordering is used by one reducer. Guys, simple guys. When ordering is done by one reducer, the work is different. When ordering is done by multiple reducers, the work is different. That is what he's trying to explain. And to enhance the performance, you can use hive.optimize.sampling.order.by is equal to 2. This is distribute by key. Distribute by key is also same thing. Hive uses the columns in distribute to distribute the rows among the reducers. In other words, all the rows with same distributed columns will go to same reducer. Okay. Candid examples, I've given it here. You can have a look how the reducer works and how things will work. Okay. Same things I've explained more clearly here. When you have time, go through it. Okay, and this is nothing but storing your results to a file. This is all already covered as a part of our MapReduce configurations and properties, hyphen D and all the things. Sorry for that. This is Hive join strategies. Actually, you may not need them, but I have added this for your information. This is to just to explain you how internally, just drag this diagram when you have time, have a look. Just drag this diagram, try to understand what you have in customers table, what you have in orders table, what exactly is happening when you shuffle the joins from customer table and orders table. Okay, it's a very good example. Specifying the MapReduce properties, this example guys, very simple. It is telling for this specific job, use 12 reducers. Okay. And for this jar, you are telling the setting high var flag equal to 33, means you want the properties to be persistent with the configuration changes given. Here you are telling use 12 reducers. Okay. And if you go here, insert overwrite. This I have shown you already with a set example. Loading data from local directory into Hive, one as a managed table, one as external table, one as external table with different location. I have loaded the data perfectly. I have dropped the table. I have also shown you what happens when I drop the table. So that thing we are pretty perfect. With this one, we have covered Hive very precisely. Shuffle joins and broadcast joins, you don't need them at the moment. But when you are deeply involved in development strategies, you can have a look. So I don't think you'll be needing that level of development at the moment, as we are in the starting phase of understanding how these things works. Okay. And this is also same thing. After this, from 20 slides, from slide number 20, you just go through the slides, you'll understand everything. Okay. We have already covered order by, sort by. The same things I have given you with an example here. That's the only thing. Okay. Any questions, anyone, till this point? I have given you the all the statements. I've given you everything. Yeah, should be okay. Why I don't know why less participation these days. I'll have to stop loading videos so people will join the class. I'll stop loading videos. People join the class. Okay, I'm just kidding. That's all I have. If you have any questions, please let me know. Bhaskar, Hemant, Mahinder, Ramprasad, Shravan, Suresh. Very simple. The first 10 minutes we have struggled. Honestly, we have struggled because that syntax was for Cloudera syntax. This syntax which I have shown you, this one is for Cloudera syntax, but this is Hortonworks. I have to make necessary syntax changes to import the data from Scoop into HDFS. Once the correct syntax is done, we imported it and we did a couple of orders or joins and understood how things works. Anything else, anyone? If you have any questions, let me know. Otherwise, I'll make a move. Guys, if you have questions, say yes. If you have no questions, say no. Okay, perfect. Hemant, any questions? Mahinder, Ramprasad? Okay. Ramprasad, you have a question? No, okay, perfect. Thank you guys. Have a good day, everyone. Enjoy your work. I'll see you tomorrow. With this, we have completed five. I'll explain you a bit about Flume and after that Spark. Thanks everyone. Have a great day. Enjoy your work.